It's been a while.
Yeah, cutting back to this.
You guys hear that?
Yes. Hear the shittiness of my voice?
Yeah, you said you're having trouble today.
Yeah, my voice is going out. Probably because I'm a loud person. So we're on...
We haven't streamed anything this past couple days, though, so...
Did we? I thought no. We streamed Lagoon at some point.
Well, yeah, but that wasn't, All we did in Lagoon was talk about Seinfeld RPGs. Nothing rage-inducing.
Mm. No, it was probably something when we were watching something. I was really loud during the... During us watching... What we watched? We watched an episode of MLP.
We watched a really weird episode of one thing, and then it was MLP, and then we watched a really weird episode of Jackie Chan was first.
We started with Jackie Chan, in which one of the characters got a demon mask on his ass.
They got away with some pretty sketchy puns that episode.
Yes, yes.
You're looking heinous today.
That was the entirety of that episode, was just making those kinds of jokes. With unusually high animation quality.
Then you're trying to wrap your head around ponies, and then there was Code Lyoko.
And then there was Code Lyoko, which was pretty tame, all things considered.
Yeah. What episode was that?
That was the one where tries to game the lottery using time travel.
Yeah, time travel, time scumming.
Yeah, time scum.
Real life hacks.
So, this... So if I remember correctly, the next chapter is the one with the creepy forest.
We're on Twilight Town.
This fucked with me the first time I played this chapter.
Yeah.
You know what's coming.
Yeah. Honestly, I don't dislike it as a chapter, despite... I think despite it having a stupid amount of backtracking across the same maps a lot.
Yeah.
Like, the chapter itself, conceptually, is, fun enough that I don't mind it as much. Would have been better without the backtracking, mind you.
Yeah. So... What we talked about, didn't we talk about, the theology of this world last stream? Or, last time we...
Well, we talked about it a lot in the last game, the Star Cultists.
Yeah. Well, Star Cultism is, the default religion, because majority of people are thank the stars, and stars have, immense godlike powers and shit.
Yeah, it's only a cult if it's a minority.
No, it's a star religion.
Yeah.
Monotheism is the cult in this universe.
Is it mono? It's multi polytheism.
No, I'm saying monotheism is in the minority, therefore it's a cult.
Yeah, I see what you're saying, yeah.
Nice Jamaican looking lights on that computer.
Oh, right, yeah.
Alright, so Tech, the story of a robot who learned how to love. Dude.
Death battle, Tech versus Hal.
Tech versus GLaDOS.
Yeah.
Just.
GLaDOS only learned how to hate.
Well, GLaDOS learned how to hate after you destroyed the core with the capacity to love. That's what she needed. She needed a personality core that was all, I love you.
Yeah, she needed more Moe.
She needed her... Yeah, Moe
core. Can you imagine Tsundere GLaDOS?
Oh, God. Isn't that her default personality, though?
I guess.
She's murderously Tsundere.
Once she was a potato, she got a little more Tsundere.
Well, that's because she was disconnected from, the main body, which was responsible for all the testing. Oh, is this the Metal Gear Solid portion?
Oh, we're going up to do something.
Yeah, you were doing stealth. Oh, man.
Good stealth music we got.
Fucking demented toy box music.
Just a moment. Waddle, waddle, waddle.
Man, these X-knots. Sorry, cross-knots.
Oh, right, yeah, that's what... I guess that's what we're supposed to assume
they're pronounced. DS-knots. DS-knots.
Yeah. Since there were cross-yucks.
Yeah, X...
Please change here, quickly. I will watch for posterity.
I will watch your posterity. Oh. This is the most implausible disguise.
Yeah. I have to wear this ugly thing.
Yes.
Come on, squeeze, princess. If you can manage a quartet, you can manage this. I'm in a corset, not quartet.
Manage a quartet.
Flawless!
That's fucking impressive.
Can't jump. Can't attack. Can't do anything.
Peach. Which is strange, because Peach has the ability to fly.
Sup, Grotus, bro?
Grotus!
What is it?
Yes, what is it? Well, it's about Princess Peach. What do you plan to do with her going forward?
Are you gonna rape her?
No! Not a Nintendo game. Not even Bowser does that.
Yeah.
That we know of.
Apparently there was, cut parts of the Lion King where Scar implied that he would rape Nala.
Wait, what?
Yeah. And also,
wait, what?
And also, Nala and Simba may have been siblings.
Wait, what? You're fucking with me.
And also, Scar didn't throw Mufasa...
What fanfic have you been reading?
Also, Scar didn't throw Mufasa off a cliff. He broke his neck and his jaws. This was the original script, reports have said.
Dude, I would have loved to see that script.
Yeah.
It would have been a completely different Disney.
I watched a Dorkly video about it earlier, and Disney Disney movies that changed heavily over the course of their conception.
I want to read that script.
There was footage of it, so presumably this had to have been in the special features of the DVD or something.
No, it wouldn't. Like,
there was animated footage of it.
I'm not doubting that it exists. I'm saying they wouldn't put that on a DVD. Where any kid could... You imagine a kid, like, browsing
the special...
Kids don't
watch special features. Those are for weirdos like me.
Well, weirdos like you were kids once.
I didn't check the special features when I was a kid. We didn't have DVDs. I was watching VHS and I had my Riding Bean trailers at the start.
Alright, so...
Did you watch special features as a kid?
13, yeah.
Eh.
Because I don't know, there was nothing to do.
13, you're old enough for Scar breaking necks.
Okay, so Scar didn't throw Simba off the cliff. He snapped
No, Mufasa.
His neck.
That's how he killed Mufasa.
Okay.
In the Simba fight, actually fell instead of Scar. But survived, and then the flames climbed up Pride Rock and Scar was trapped and he just laughed maniacally as he burned alive.
Well, that's just luck. I like the other one better, but... So in that one, Scar implied that he was gonna rape Nala?
Well,
his
yeah.
Simba's sister?
Yeah.
Were they still gonna get down to fuck in that movie?
Presumably, yeah. That was still an element.
Who wrote this original script? George R. R. Martin?
I mean, you know, lion prides only have, like, two or three males and a bunch of females.
Oh.
Can you remember any male lions besides Mufasa and Scar in that pride?
Simba?
Any male adult lions?
There
were just those two and all the females.
the harem. Alright.
Inbreeding common among lions, apparently.
Common and apparently lions are unaffected.
Yeah.
Wow, my voice sounds like shit. God! Wait!
What?
Fire. Oh!
Oh, the music?
Yeah.
You got a text?
No. I just want to do. Inbred lions. Oh. Here's an inbred lion.
Okay, that looks like a liger.
No, wow! Look at how grumpy that lion looks. Or tiger. Oh, that's a tiger. Why the fuck are you showing me a tiger? I'm looking for a lion.
Well, maybe it couldn't find any pictures of lions who were inbred and weren't obviously looked that way. One of the evildoers, you want our crystal star!
How rude! Oh, even when big, he's smaller than Bowser. She's smaller than Bowser. So,
it's Hag versus Hag. Awesome.
You look as if you're just dying to say something.
Oh, he didn't actually say it.
Elder Hag thing.
Hag thing. Oh.
It's gone.
Mario.
We gave it to a mustachioed man named Martio.
Martio. Ricky O.
Yeah.
They send Mario.
He's off to save Princess Pinch. That send, lucky lass.
They send Mario to prison. And wait, wasn't Bowser at like fucking he was at the glitz pit, right?
Yeah. So
and now he's down here.
He went backwards. I guess he got to the glitz pit and then started following Mario's steps back. He went to Don Pianta and all that shit.
Where the fuck did he come from?
Huh?
That's what Bowser's saying. Like, all right, he's here now, but where was he from?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, it's Rock Hawk.
Glitzville was Bowser's chapter 2.
So now you must leave. I understand. We won't delay you. Good luck.
I must follow a man's path. Gonzales, I want to tell you. Rock Hawk ain't gonna fight dirty anymore.
Rock Hawk face turned. At the end of the beginning of his undefeated streak.
Yeah. Oh, and the Gangsta Turtle's back, Randy.
Oh, he unretired.
Yeah. We got Randy Jackson and Randy Savage.
Yeah. Oh, those two are there just, I guess, fuming.
Hanging out
with the family.
Nah, I'm sure they're cool now. See, if you lose to a guy and then he becomes the champion, then that's okay, because obviously we're gonna lose to him. If you lose to a guy and then he gets his ass kicked, now that's embarrassing.
Yeah. I feel bad for those, like, people in the tournament, like, in a tournament that, like, lose to somebody and then they immediately lose to, like, somebody else. It's like, oh man, I'm a nobody.
Yeah. Alright, we're off. Back to Rogueport.
DIY. Do-it-yourself fame. Xelrog has just left. Alright.
Sorry.
It's fine. So the glitz pit is done and dusted. Y'all need to
for
go back
now.
There. Ready? Oh, where?
No, we? Never again. We'll never have to go back there.
We will. Won't we? I legitimately forgot.
Oh yeah.
Well, so there goes that. Now we can go to the haunted forest.
Sorry, Goombella. You've been replaced. By Dragon!
For now. We'll still need her to, like, check on stuff.
Waddle, waddle, waddle. Okay, so we have the Yoshi now. We can access... Oh.
Wait. You got an email, Gonzales.
I can't not check it. I don't have that choice.
Yeah.
I've uncovered something terrible. They're planning to take control of the world. God
and,
damn it.
And then what?
Call me shocked.
Oh, is that all? Another... You guessed it, take over the world. Of course!
What the fuck did you think they were after?
So, there's this running gag somewhere where, like... Are you aware of Street Fighter the movie's existence?
I've seen one of the Street Fighter movies. Are you talking about the live action one or
yes.
The animated? No, I haven't seen the live
okay.
action. I've seen one of the anime movies.
So the M. Bison in that one is like... somebody. I guess the context is somebody asks him, hey... Are you planning on taking over the world? He goes, of course! I'm like...
Yeah?
That movie was pretty funny. It was
Who played M. Bison?
Raul Julia. It is famously his last role. He was, like, dying of cancer. He could only do one more movie. And, like, he asked, like, either his kids or his grandkids. I forget which.
Yeah.
Like, I got several movies available for me. Which one do you want to see me do? And they're like, Street Fighter 2! And he looked over the script, saw it was shit, and was like, I'll do it! He was the best, apparently the best part of that movie, because he just acted his ass off.
He is about the one thing that people remember fondly from the movie, from what I've heard.
Yeah, it just goes to show a good character and good performance can make or break a film.
Yeah. I mean, still didn't make the film, but
it came close, though.
Yeah.
If only Jean-Claude Van Damme gave as much of a shit.
Yeah.
Guile. You get a French dude to play Guile, you should be shot.
You gotta get the French dude to play Dudley.
Yeah, he's English, but that's closer. Dude, Jean-Claude Van Damme could have played Vega.
Yeah.
That would have been good.
Yeah.
What was Jumpman? Is that one?
Increases jump, but lose hammer.
Nah, that's impractical. Oh, wait, you're getting it?
I'm gonna get it just because...
Are you serious?
I'm gonna get it just because his stuff changes. And I want to try to collect.
Alright.
And I checked the bad shop. There's nothing better there to spend my money on.
Alright, fine. Hope you don't need Nins soon.
We'll get more coins. I've got in coupons. In coupons for days!
Just imagine, like, you want to be really cheap in spending, spending cash, so you... Every time you get hurt, you leg it all the way back to the Glitz Pit and just use their free healing. And then you come back!
Actually, they thought of that.
They did?
I don't have enough shine sprites. Be gone!
Wait, how did they think of that?
Well... I think it takes place now, or it might be after we finish a chapter, but... If you go back to the Glitz Pit and try to... like, go back in any of the rooms or try to fight again, your record's been deleted.
Really?
You have to start from the beginning again, remember?
That's still free healing, because the...
But you can't enter the champion's room and heal your star power without becoming champion again.
Well, that's what I'm saying, it's just free healing.
I guess, yeah. In the same way that, yeah.
My point is still proven. You can still trek back there and get free healing. Not good healing, free healing. Oh, do we not, fill the map out?
No, we gotta go back down to the place. Do the thing. Julie, do the thing!
Do the thing, Julie.
I guess I don't really get access to any real new areas with the Yoshi yet. Oh, I got the super hammer, though.
Oh, yeah, you can access stuff there now.
Aha! All right, I gotta do the thing.
Yeah, it's not that powerful. Shine sprite. Dude, I sound miserable right now.
You don't sound great.
I'm like, you were hoping to stream. I'm like, okay, yeah, we'll stream. I'm gonna sound like shit, but we'll stream.
Yeah. That's okay, though. Yeah. I'm the one playing. You don't need to...
I still have voice acting to do. I hope this isn't permanent.
Yeah. Yeah, it won't
be. I mean, not now, but...
No. Alright, so now
maybe
we have
Petalburg. Voice.
Now you can do Roshi?
Russian voice.
Oh. Because you sound tired?
Do I sound tired?
You sound like very raspy, I guess is the word.
Ugh. I'm Kinpachi.
I don't think that'll help.
No, but I can do it easier.
Yeah. Take up smoking. That's great for that kind of voice.
All I voice are deep voice smoker gangster characters.
Yeah.
Hey, you got a Yakuza in an anime? I'll voice him. I'll make him sound fucking intimidating. It's got a lot of garlic, so maybe that'll help.
Is that good for voices?
If I'm sick, that'll help. that works! Okay.
Shortcut. You'd have some tea. I don't know if Earl Grey helps. I've got, like, lemon ginger tea.
I get Earl. I mainly drink Earl Grey because Captain Picard's drink of choice.
Yeah.
He always goes to the fucking replicator and his downtime's like, tea, Earl Grey, hot.
Yeah.
He just drinks it and just knows, and he knows he's awesome, so he's not gonna do shit. Wait.
It's a very plain tea. Earl Grey.
Yeah.
I'm not as much a fan.
So, in original Star Trek, there was fucking just Captain Kirk, whose big thing was that he would defy orders and just go and, like, have sex with alien chicks and stuff.
Yeah, he was the Connery.
Yeah. Then you had Captain Picard, who was, like, all business, a fucking diplomatic genius.
The thinker. The second James Bond. Who is Jack? No.
Not Pierce Brosnan. There was two the top tier Bonds were Sean Connery, and then afterwards it was what was his name?
Because there was Connery was the big thing, was he was the action Bond who was always going into fist fights, and then they tried to change that image when another actor took over to try to make him more of a thinker, using his wits to get out of problems.
Oh, yeah. Fuck.
And that's kind of the same
thing. I know who you're talking about. I just don't know his... Hold on. James Bond.
He was the second or third James Bond?
Second, I'm thinking. Oh.
Well, there was... They tried to replace Connery once, and it was the worst James Bond movie ever. And that guy was only in that one movie, and they got Connery back for another movie after that. Okay. And then they replaced Connery long
as term. I'm not disagreeing with you, but as somebody who's watched, like, almost every single James Bond movie, I think you're close, but you're misinterpreting how it goes.
Okay.
All right, so, films.
Let's look up a list of Bond actors.
Oh, here we go. Dr. No is the first shock... Dr. No, From Russia With Love, and Goldfinger were all Sean Connery. Alright, Thunderball. Which one was this one? Oh, wait. No, I'm wrong. Sorry.
So it's exactly like I said?
Okay. Sean Connery from 1962 to 1967. And From Russia With Love... Roger Moore is the next one after that.
Is the next long-term one.
Oh, shit.
Just look up list of Bond actors.
This is the list!
Well, obviously not. You're...
Whatever. Okay, they replaced him with David Niven in 1967.
For one movie, right?
Yes.
And then they got Connery back for another movie after that.
No, then they got George Lazenby.
Oh.
Who was, Oh, wait. Oh, he accidentally punched a pro wrestler. That's great. He did one film, Honor, Majesty, Secret Service.
Yeah.
That was the one. Then he was replaced by... And that was his only film, and then Connery did some more. Then, after that, they did Roger Moore.
Okay.
That was the... And then...
Roger Moore sounds like the one.
Yeah, and Roger Moore is the next long-term Bond from 73 to 85.
Hmm. I was saying that was, like, basically the same thing as Kirk versus Picard. The rough and tumble versus the thinker diplomat.
Yeah. Well, they also had... They had a Kirk-like character in Next Generation. That was William Riker.
Yeah.
Like, he had two modes. First, he was, like, beardless. Then he had a beard. And, the bearded one is by far the best one. It's the same actor. He just didn't have a beard in the first season.
I get lonely and I go into Coop's house and I smell that Coop smell. No!
Wait, what?!
Not reading past that!
I'm sorry, what did I stumble upon?
Yeah, there is a game going on despite our Star Trek conversation.
Star Trek / James Bond.
Yeah.
God, can you imagine? I'm just thinking of James Bond as like a captain of a fucking starship.
Epic crossover.
The USS, I'm trying to think. United Star Systems. What would be a Connery-like ship name? James Bond-like ship name. The England? The USS England?
Sure.
And then he's the captain, and Q's is like Chief Fop- or, yeah. Yeah, he's Q and-
The USS Martini.
No. They're not- They're serious naval military.
Yeah.
You solved the trouble.
Yeah.
What trouble?
I guess I actually didn't need to do that. Now I have access to this house.
What is this house?
We don't have much here, but make yourself at home if you want. Oh, maybe there's a star piece somewhere? What is there in here? There's gotta be something.
Empty room, psych out. Maybe it's an invisible block.
No, that was just a glitch. No, see, I know that you can get on the rooftops with Yoshi from here. But for some reason,
Good one.
For some reason, I had it in my head that you had to do the unlock thing before you could do it.
Well...
Guess not.
Not yet. Not this time, rather.
Mine.
Broadside. Oh, hey.
This.
You gonna upgrade him now?
Yeah.
Cool.
Hipster.
Wait, what?
Yeah, he's there.
Miss.
I did miss.
Better luck next time.
I want to see if I can make it. I'm trying to jump.
You can just hover to like...
I'm trying to hover. I'm just not timing it right.
Alright. You did!
I made it! Sequence breaking.
Hope you're not trapped there.
Oh no, I guess I could have done that just from over here.
Yeah. Aren't you supposed to be, like good at timing?
There's like a delay, man.
It's like... You just have to make sure you hit R first. That's it. You hit R first before you move. You just think to yourself, okay, R first, and then I can move.
Man, my controller's broke.
Sure it is.
It's the controller's fault. It's not registering.
I would laugh at you on that, but I have used that same excuse, so...
Alright, power up my Yosh.
Can you imagine a Mario game except it's like James Bond?
No. Then again, I couldn't imagine a Mario game except it's Doctor Who, but look at now.
Dude, the first Mario. The second Mario.
Yeah.
The third Mario.
Well, I mean, we did have,
Mario regenerates, but it's just the same Mario.
I mean, we have had... Whoever that one was, that we had, Captain Lou Albano. We had Charles Martinet. We've had Mario.
You do drugs, you go to hell before you die. I don't know if he was actually trying to be Mario in that one, or if he just happened to be wearing a Mario hat.
He did do the voice of Mario in the Super Mario Brothers Super Show.
Ah.
There was all. I think someone else voiced him in the Mario 3 cartoon, though.
Ah.
While still having a Brooklyn accent.
Well, it's even more like Doctor Who now, because Mario's going on an odyssey.
Ooh. Pipe.
Oh, the Switch is out. By the way.
Oh, yeah?
I think it's out right now. I figured you'd want to know about that, in case you're planning on making
it. Oh, right, yeah, because Vinny did a Breath of the Wild stream I saw.
Ah. No, Breath of the Wild does well.
I mean, not that I'll be able to afford a Switch anytime soon, so it really makes no difference to me.
Yeah. You might. Sometime this month. No, all that money's gonna go somewhere else, I know it.
Yeah.
If you guys want to donate stuff, feel free.
We're shilling now.
Yeah.
The pipe rejected you.
Rejected. You're not gonna read that sign.
The pipe is tsundere. It's Twilight Town, it said the sign.
Twilight. Oh no.
Oh, that's not what I wanted
Your
to do.
Your foe has struck first.
I tried to jump on the Yoshi when I shouldn't have.
You take him.
I don't remember if I have any damage boosting badges. I don't think I do. Nope. Oh, yes! Fuck you,
that was
RNG!
Lucky.
1 star point. These guys are already worthless. So you actually cannot get 0 star points for any fight in this game, but if you get 0 star points, it bumps it up to 1 star point.
So it makes grinding viable.
Wow.
Well, it makes grinding possible, not viable.
Yeah. Frankly, we need help.
Frankly.
Pipes being tsundere.
So Sprinkly's like complaining about something to his wife, and she just won't shut up about it, and then. No, Frankly's complaining something to his wife and he won't shut up about it, and she's constantly hearing it, and finally he's like saying, honey, what do you think? And then she turns around and says, Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
Da da da. Got any drain cleaner? You can't get through the pipe, you say. How odd.
So I mentioned that Scarface is a video game.
Yeah.
And it's great. They got a guy who sounds really, really close to his voice in Al, like, as Al Pacino.
Yeah.
And like, his Tony Montana voice.
Yeah.
And it's uncannily the same. And, and he's like, it's like a Grand Theft Auto game, except it's Tony Montana. And he just doesn't shoot civilians.
Yeah.
And he's... And when they explain minor plot details, he just does it the Tony Montana way. He's like, yeah, I got a cell phone now. Russians may be listening to me, but I don't give a fuck.
Just need to have something that has your name written on it. Don't you have anything? Everyone does.
What's your name?
I'll write it on the CD or overalls. The rest of the game, Mario's just walking around with his name printed on his ass. I'll write your partner's name, too.
Depends on who's asking. For you, I am Flurry.
Just flirt with everyone. A bit to the left.
Is that why you chose her?
She's naked. She doesn't have any clothes to put draw on.
That doesn't stop those people online from, like, writing down, like, a date or something on their bare tits.
Goombella, if you do it with Goombella, she says it tickles, but she's wearing pants, so...
I wonder what, We should look up a script for this game.
Yeah?
I know there's one in GameFAQs. If I'm gonna be doing nothing but watching you, I'm gonna make myself useful.
Yeah.
Alright, so we're going to Twilight Town. Gonna run into, Sora and, or Aroxys and his gang. Fight the Heartless.
Was that Twilight Town?
That was called Twilight Town.
What was it called in Kingdom Hearts 1?
It was Traverse Town. It was a completely separate location.
Okay.
Top 10 silent protagonists in RPGs. No thank you, game FAQs. How the fuck is game FAQs still relevant?
I don't know.
Because people always need help with shit. That's great.
Alright, only 30 minutes in and we got the chapter title screen.
Yeah, these tend to be longer streams.
Yeah, so. 2 hours, 2.5 per chapter. Sure is Twilight. Spookily dookily. We've entered the village.
The village. So, what if we just started turning into survival horror right now? Not like this pig shit, but like, there's actual,
Like a slasher?
Yeah, there's like a Jason Voorhees, like, character just after you.
Yeah.
And then like, the sirens are like, what? That's not with us, is he with you?
But if you're over here, then that means...
Then they gotta do a team-up.
Yeah. Freddy got turned into a pig. That's what they said.
Freddy.
His name was Freddy.
Oh, Freddy Krueger, poor bastard.
Some call me Dower. Jerks.
I am Dower.
Yes, that is my name. Don't make fun of it.
It's like the dude in Slayer. It's like when Gowry is encountering that dude in the Slayer. He's like, oh, I remember you. You're John, right? We've never met! Wiser.
Did he say that?
Yeah, Gowry called him Inspector John or something.
Oh, I thought you came up with that.
No, he's like, you're John, right?
John Wiser.
Played by Crispin Freeman.
Dan Green.
Dan Green?
Yeah.
Aw, damn it.
Now cluck like a chicken. Okay, so when the bell...
I want to see your guide! Thank you.
When the bell rings, someone gets turned into a pig. Oh no.
Okay.
Some horrible shit. What's Goombella have to say about the pigs?
Game script, here we go.
That's a Twilighter who got turned into a pig.
He's been forced to
sniff out truffles.
Oh, oh god, this. Oh, look, birds!
Yep.
I wonder what they have to say. poor ladies.
I feel like I've met these pigs before. The traveling toad sisters traveled to the wrong place.
Talk to the pigs. Or not the pigs, the birds.
A nasty monster lives in the woods past here. I'm serious.
Of course, there's always a monster in the woods. I bet if I go to the woods around here, I'll encounter something horrifying.
There's always a gatekeeper, too.
Just go out in the middle of the woods, I'll see, like, a guy dressed in flannel and jeans, like, don't go out here, there's a monster!
Yeah.
I'm like, I got a machete, is that gonna help?
What's going on in here? I haven't been able to buy food for my children since my husband turned into a pig.
Oh, you could do it.
I'm hungry!
Can you give him some mushrooms to, like...
If you have some spare food, could you share it with us?
What do we got? We got...
Eat this! I don't think that's edible.
Oh, well, okay. Sorry.
I understand. Don't worry about it.
Alright. No!
Well, enjoy your slow and painful death, children.
We couldn't save them? Shit!
Goodbye, children!
Bye, Chef. Fuck, this game is a long script.
Control F?
Whatever.
Oh no, the mayor's a pig!
There's this mysterious bell. Why aren't you talking to the birds?
Because we can't yet.
You can. They'll say something.
The birds.
Oh, look. Cow, they're saying cow. What does Gumbella have to say about him?
Nothing.
Oh. So, she just ignores the birds?
Yeah.
It's weird.
Sniff, sniff. Le-oink.
Le-oink.
We're not open. My husband's been turned into a pig. I think it's because I called him a pig when he was a man.
Now, here's the question.
Oh, that's exactly what she said.
Can you imagine if they were turned into pigs in a very awkward situation?
What, like they were fucking? And yeah, just one of them suddenly a pig?
The first ever case of accidental bestiality.
Yeah.
That's something you could never... Oh. I bet the wife turned into... Oh, the gatekeeper's turned into a pig.
Well, not to be insensitive, but that works out for us.
Yeah, that worked.
Bye. As if he could have stopped you when he was a human.
Like, it's like, are you serious? What are you gonna do?
Twilight or whatever the hell he was.
Twilight, yeah. Man, Twilight, get your shit together. Twilight Town. It's just a magical unicorn with wings versus a bunch of vampires.
Whoops!
like is it?
Vampires versus unicorns. Which one sparkles best? I remember you fuckers from the last game.
You guys suck.
It's a hyperactive Goomba. It looks mutated.
And this duck goes, bzzow! Bzzow.
If you can't beat him, then run away, okay? Bah, you bitch.
If you can't beat him, then run away.
At least super guarding exists in this game.
Yeah.
Unreliable as it may be in my hands.
Yeah. Oh!
Oh, you're gonna charge, huh? No?
3 damage. All right, is amazing. Geez.
I must have like power up P equipped or something.
Probably. That's what I would do.
Cause we don't have access to ultra ranking partners yet.
Yeah.
I don't think.
No. Doesn't that cost, like, more shine sprites?
It, no, it's 3 every time.
Ah. Alright, well, just what I know.
What's our badges like?
We haven't done this in a while. We should probably check.
Multi-bounce. So, lots of moves. I probably don't need.
Yeah, we got a bunch of HP up stuff. 1 FP up stuff. Yeah, we do. Power plus FP.
Yeah.
Alright, power plus P.
Last stand. Alright,
wait, what the fuck was up to- Double pain?
Yeah!
Okay, badges like that should give you, like, more badge points.
Yeah.
Like, negative badge points.
Increase jump power, but lose your hammer ability.
Dude, that would be so popular, like, badge points that- Badges that allow, like, disadvantages so you gain more badge points.
Yeah.
That's like, the very definition of min-maxing.
Yeah. These are just a bunch of Jake blocks.
Yeah. Wasn't it like the Emmanuel said that Toads have been turned into blocks and that's why Mario's destroying them?
In Mario 1, that was the story.
Well, that was the story according to
the manual.
Yeah, which was written by nobody who worked on the game.
You don't know that.
The manual didn't know whether Birdo was a male or a female in Super Mario Bros. 2.
No, the manual knew exactly what he was.
Alright. No. Wait, why are skeletons watching our match?
Oh, you know, it's their turf. Skeletons can't be sports fans?
Oh, I guess the skeletons in this world are non-violent?
Wow, I mean, there were the skeletons in Hooktail Castle were pretty violent.
Yeah, but I don't think there are skeleton enemies in this, in Twilight Town.
Oh, no, not
or
here.
In the woods. No, so there's skeletons here, but they're not of, like, they're not violent enough to want Mario dead if he's on their turf.
Yeah. Actually, turns out only a very small minority of enemies are aggro. The others just like to watch the fights.
It's Mario. Well, who would want to fuck with Mario? Mario's the John Wick of this universe.
Yeah, these are the real crazy motherfuckers. Got nothing to lose.
tell them that I'll give you an extra. I'll give them an extra 300 coins if they take Mario on.
Oh boy, a dried shroom.
Cutie's favorite. Tell them I'll give them 300 extra coins and take Mario out of an inn. They violate continental rules.
Yeah. Dizzy. A chance. It lost its animation.
Dude. If like Dizzy it tries to power up, there should be a chance for it to miss.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, just I'm so dizzy I accidentally buffed Mario.
Goomba hurt itself in confusion. Ah, fuck it. Oh.
Oh! That's
thank
going.
You!
Increased damage.
Yeah.
Let's see how much it'll be.
At exactly the right time, it'll finish it.
It's 9 damage! Holy shit!
Woohoo! Yeah, go the fuck with me!
Good luck with that, buddy.
Bowser's, and breakdance.
I just got a mental image of Bowser running through a club and Mario's just hot. He's like walking hot on his trail.
Bowser or Bowser Jr.?
That would be... No, if we're... That would be like Bowser Jr. Level up.
That no one was Mario!
Uh-oh. I heard you struck my son! And then the Koopa, rather than being scared of Bowser, is like, yes, I did, sir.
Why?
Because he stole Mario's hammer, sir, and, killed his brother.
Oh.
Dude, you killed Luigi. Mario would flip out and go on a genocidal rampage.
Yeah.
Like...
Alright, we are now Majin Buu again.
Awesome. Minor healing. That's good. Maybe. Mario's just been like Mario. He's at this point just become an icon.
Yeah. What's like, gonna happen when Charles Martinet dies? Mario's gonna outlive the voice, right?
Yeah, everybody outlives the voice.
Yeah.
Like, that's the thing with fictional characters is that if they're like drawn and like they exist in animation and stuff, you can have as many people as you want. I'm sure there's somebody who can pull off a Mario voice.
Like me!
Yeah, you should audition if he dies. Or retires. Whichever.
Are we gonna kill Charles Martinet?
No!
Well, just indirectly.
Are you serious?
Indirectly, like by talking about this. Is he gonna die and then we're gonna feel bad?
How old is he?
I don't know.
I'm sure he's got like 5 years left in him.
Hopeful.
That did come off worse than I intended.
Turns out he's like 30. He's
all right.
Older than that. But.
All right. Well, we'll solve this. Charles Martinet.
According to Wikipedia, Charles Martinet is an American actor and voice actor.
Yeah, we know that.
He voices all of them.
He's got gray hair, so.
He voices all of the Mario siblings, by the way. Mario, Luigi, Wario, and Waluigi.
Oh, no! Oh, you might have to get, like, 3 other voice actors. He's 61.
Oh, that's not bad.
That's not bad. He's...
Oh, I got defense plus.
Barring something... Oh,
I remember these things. I just heard a voice!
I'll have to curse you now.
You said you've seen a chest like this before? Get out of here! I'm not like, oh, right, we've run into 2. Don't make me beg. I'm not like those other chests. I'm just going to give you a new ability. Doesn't that sound nice?
He does. To be fair, he's not lying.
Yeah. Alright, here's your stupid key.
Wee-hee.
Fools!
It was secretly Terracuda all along.
This guy's not chill enough to be Terracuda.
Oh, yeah. Terracuda. Okay, so Jackie Chan Adventures, like, you get, like, the standard, like, look squad of, Irishman Finn.
Well, let's go through. Season 1 was Shendu season.
Oh, no, season 1 was Valmont working under Shendu.
Yeah, Valmont, the classy British mob leader, and Shendu, evil, no-nonsense dragon overlord.
Sealed it as stone. And he gets really impatient, like, you're useless, you fools!
Season 2 was Daolon Wong.
Season 2 was also Shindu.
Well, yeah, but it turned into Daolon Wong.
At the very end.
Was that Season 3 that was
no,
all about the
animals? Season
3
was all about, Season 3 was all about the animals. Season 2 was,
filler. A whole season of filler.
Shindu is dead. That was that season. Was, Shindu has died.
But it was mostly filler. Just random episodes.
The second half was filler, yes.
It was just random episodes.
Yeah, because they only had enough plot for like 13 episodes, I guess.
Then season 3 was Daolon Wong, evil ancient chi wizard, who was also very no-nonsense. Dude, you're useless!
But to be fair, he was much better than Shindu. He's much cooler. He's a cool old guy.
Yeah, because he was blatantly an evil wizard.
Also, he was the worst boss because he conscripted like all like the Mook Squad, Finn, Ratso, the suit dude with like
Chow.
With like he was the big guy of the group, and then Chow, the token Asian dude.
Yeah.
And then they were just conscripted to being like dark warriors or whatever.
Yeah.
They're, like possessed.
The Daolon Wong was awesome because he was blatantly an evil wizard in all settings.
Yes.
Just walks into a fast food restaurant and starts shooting dark energy blasts and shit.
I have
no fucks.
God, it was great. And then now, this
season four.
Season 4 we're watching. They're doing a little Japanese mythology. Then there's this Oni called Terracuda who's explicitly just a talking head.
Yeah.
And he's very chill with their failures. He's like, whatever.
You know, I expected this. We'll try again tomorrow.
He's not blaming them for their failures, just the fact that Jackie Chan is just so good
even
in that series.
Dropped some puns in here and there. He's a really chill villain compared to all the rest in the series.
It was just kind of a breath of fresh air, because if you don't like the way a guy is doing, you just fire him. That's it. Anyway, Mario. Into the forest.
Yep. The very narrow, narrow forest where there's it's very difficult to avoid enemies.
God.
Some of these trees have shit behind them.
Oh! Oh! This is the grinding spot of this game. Comes in chapter
really.
4.
No, it's not as effective here.
Oh, yeah, because what is it? You gotta reset your game every time to respawn to them?
Something like that. Something, or walk all the way back to Twilight Town. It's something really inconvenient.
Yeah, so it's, but it's still amazing pieces, and they're still worth a lot.
Not enough to make it worth the inconvenience. The better method, honestly, is to just, you know, go in the pit of 100 trials.
Oh, that one.
Where by the bottom you get groups of amazing daisies.
Fair enough. Never mind me.
Oh.
Oh no.
Almost got it.
I hate it.
I don't think. Okay. Sleep does not stack in this game. And in fact, getting hit while you're asleep has a chance to wake you. So they fixed the stun locking.
Yeah. Fuck it.
And now it runs away. Yep. Thank God sleep doesn't last after battle.
How would that even work? Oh no, we can't wake Mario up.
You just wander around the map as a partner until Mario wakes up of his own accord.
Oh no, he's infected with sleep. What do we do? Better go to the inn so we can wake up eventually.
Yeah, we gotta get an awakening.
I always dislike sleep as a status effect.
Yeah.
In games, because it's like, well, just the other guy could just slap him, and paralysis as a status effect makes more sense.
Yeah.
Or like confusion. That works well.
Yeah.
As well.
Frozen. Well, that's unrealistic because if you get frozen, you're dead.
I guess if I'm being that nitpicky, that would also count, huh?
All right, let's quake this shit.
The Amazing Daisy is gonna retreat.
I don't think it's low enough. Oh.
Yeah, he's just run.
You know your cowardice.
You abandoned your friend, you dick.
Left him to die with his belly up wide open.
Hey, Mario.
All right, what do you
hey,
got?
Hey, Peach.
Hammer throw.
Noise complaint. Noise complaint. I can't do a high voice in this state.
Yeah.
Sorry.
This took me longer than it needed to.
Oh, really? Yeah, there's no obvious, like sign that was what you would do. Like, no, like, paper curving or anything. Into the woods. It's quiet. Too quiet. Wow, you really need her.
Yeah. What would we do without you, Flurry?
Not finish the game.
But our Rule 34 page would look a lot nicer. I don't know, I'm sure someone's made some legitimately sexy Flurry pictures.
I'm sure.
There it is. Hello, Chiyubu.
Thank you for stopping by this creepy... I mean, it's good that this is coming out now, because apparently there are some good horror films in the dump months this year, so...
Are
it's
there?
Fitting, yeah.
It's coming
Split.
Out.
Split was really good. Get Out, obviously.
Oh, you're talking about... Like, that have come out?
Yes.
Not that are coming out.
Yeah. Also, Raw is coming out soon. Which is a movie about a girl who slowly becomes a cannibal, apparently.
Oh.
Like a foreign film.
And the first thing they say in chat is Rule 34.
Yep. There's nothing wrong with it.
Oh, oh shit! This room.
Oh, it's god! A spiked one.
I forgot about this room. It's not as big. It's not as big a surprise as those anti guys coming, but
yeah.
By the way, I don't think we ever got around to that one anti guy in the chest in the previous game. We did.
Yeah, we 100% of that game.
Huh.
We did a whole boss rush stream where we took out the anti guy and the master and the like Koopa Koop.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Then I don't know why you keep forgetting about that. Buzzy beetles.
Basically, just fireproof Koopas.
Dang it.
You're weak.
Yeah.
I like how Goombella is our strongest member right now.
Against all odds.
Then again, if we had the multi-hit character, they'd do gangbusters with the attack plus.
Yeah.
Wow, that's gonna be broken when we get that one.
Attack plus. For Mario?
No.
For partner? We already have that.
No, for the partner that has the multi-hit attack.
Oh, yeah!
The one that hits like 5 or 6 times.
Isn't that...
The secret one.
Oh! Oh, her. Okay, never mind. I thought you were talking about... what did we name her, Yoshi?
Dragon.
Okay, Dragon.
Because we didn't get the black one.
Dang it.
This Buzzy Beetle is just the scout.
Oh, you too. Nice!
Are you guys going 100% this game?
As much as we can, I guess. As much as we remember.
I guess it depends. Probably not on camera, maybe. We'll see if we're still interested enough to do, like, all the Trouble Center stuff. I think we should definitely do the Pit of 100 Trials.
Oh, no, that's... That was a question?
Yeah, on the...
No, 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 I mean, doing the Pit of 100 Trials. That was like...
Oh, yeah.
You were, like, debating not?
No, that's something we'll definitely do.
Yeah. That's always gonna remain locked. The way you unlock it. So after not fighting Booze in the last, game...
If you're disappointed, prepare to not be disappointed.
Yeah.
I still gotta do the next. After I finish the current highlights I'm working on, I'm probably gonna go back and do the second Paper Mario bit.
Ah.
But I gotta finish that reel.
Hey, we got Ice Hammer.
Ice Smash.
You know, anti-fire. And a cookbook. Oh, we can give that to
Frankly, yes.
Yeah. Hey, Frankly, you should learn how to cook. It's pretty cool.
With this, you can feed her.
Swallow it, bitch!
Because he's a German character!
Is he German?
Well, we made him German. Because the Kuratsuchi voice didn't really fit for him.
My friends have been taken away.
So lonely.
Oh, is he just not gonna let you through?
No. Thought we were gonna get like an Onryo scene or something. Can you imagine it's not Booze, but this castle's haunted by a legit Onryo?
Oh my god. That would be a creepy boss. It has an attack where it just crawls at you looking at you through the television.
I want to see that legitimately where it's otherwise a very normal, like, Nintendo-y game, except there's just that one part, that one boss or something, that is, like, legit horror. Like, if Buried Alive were actually in Pokemon.
Oh, shit, there's none of that in Mario. I think Majora's Mask was, like,
probably
a game
closest.
Filled with those kinds of moments.
Yeah.
That was almost a legit horror game.
You'd definitely call it that.
God, Majora's Mask was such a good game.
Yeah.
He's Mario, except it's Resident Evil 7.
It's locked.
Wait. No, he broke the seal.
Oh no. I haunted the house.
The house wasn't haunted till you came along, you fool.
It's quiz time, interloper.
There's no way to know that.
100. Aw.
So what do you get?
Thank you.
What if you get if you manage it?
Ultra Shroom.
Well, I guess it wasn't that.
Would have been nice, but
probably always static.
That's a boo. You think it's one of the boos from that box? No, I'm sure it's some unrelated boo.
Are boos friendly in this universe? Oh, you're not gonna fight the optional boss?
Don't leave me alone.
Are you gonna fight the optional boss here?
Are you going to be- YES! Then go away.
Oh. Okay. Okay.
But I wanna go away!
Alright, I guess we'll promise not to be mean to him.
If we must.
Promise!
No.
Come on out!
Spooky. At least they're not making puns this time.
Get out! Get out! What happens if you let yourself get taken again? You just end up
taken. You become Liam Neeson. They do that.
I will find you and I will kill you. Good luck.
At least it's better than Mario World, and touching them is not instant death.
Yeah. Then again, everything was instant death in Mario World.
Yeah.
There was an enemy. There's no such thing as hit points there.
So I actually never figured this out until I looked it up in a more recent playthrough.
Ah.
Because I thought, like, once you summon these guys, these were just, like, an obstacle and you had to avoid them.
Well.
Let's get him, guys!
Alright! Time to fight him, boop! Time to go ghost busting. I ain't afraid of no ghost.
Not a big boo. It's an atomic boo.
Atomic. The A-bomb.
If you get enough intangible things together, they have enough mass to constitute one atom.
Oh. There's that spiritual fallout.
Yeah. Alright, let's kick your ass, I guess. We must.
Yeah, sure.
Ooh. Ow.
4 damage, wow.
So yeah, I never figured that you could shake them off and initiate this. And so I was wondering for the longest time what that one Tatalog thing I was missing. And in the game's epilogue, it shows them reenacting this fight. And I'm like, when the fuck did that happen?
Well, you avoided a boss battle.
Yeah.
Speedrunner strats. You're gonna die.
Nah, I got this.
You don't seem to have got this the past, you know, few times.
I'm gonna treat myself.
Sniper!
The Mario ones are the important ones, and I'm gonna miss that one, damn it.
That is good ratio. You can survive another hit.
Damn it. Alright, I'll normal guard next time. Thank you!
Wait!
Traitor! Traitor!
Traitor! You are a betrayer!
No!
You're...
I would
say there can't be such a thing as a half-ghost, except Bleach exists.
God damn it.
Do it. Go for it, Scotty.
Is he charging up a super attack?
You might want to heal again, buddy. Or, you know, don't suck. You have to get really lucky with a power bounce.
No, I don't.
Fuck!
I'm good. I'm alright, I'm fine.
Peril!
Stupid God. Fat boo in his fat hitbox.
You said, oh, I got this, and then you just fuck up immediately. You almost lost.
Pretty lucky!
What does that do?
It's like the curse we have on us, but something good always happens at the start.
You had a life stream, you were fine. This entire time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's good. That's an interesting if it works badge. But you know how what I think about if it works badges?
No, something all good always happens. Always? You just don't know what it will be.
Oh, when it works. I love those.
You know what? I'm going to use it.
Yeah, sure. Show it off.
I'm also going to save.
Save and heal.
There's no heal.
No, there is.
Oh, you're right. It's out here.
It costs coins, but there is one.
But why do that when I could walk back to Glitzville?
That is a strategy you could use. if you want to. It's like you always gotta go to Firelink Shrine and Dark Souls.
Oh, now they're just normal boos. Alright, come here, you fucker.
Show them off.
Well, I got the Tatalog entry.
Yeah. Oh, you might actually just kill this one.
I don't think they have that much hit points. Despite being ghosts.
HP will briefly recover.
Ghosts in Pokemon, notorious for low hit points.
But they can't be hit by normal attacks. You try to tackle it, it's just not gonna do shit.
Nope.
The ghosts of the other game weren't really malicious, just pranksters. This one, it's kind of weird. Oh!
More luck. RNG! Just max RNG, Joey Wheeler badge build.
Spider roulette! Am I gonna lose? I don't know, let's see what this coin flip says.
Swoop!
Good. Nice.
Electrified.
Oh my god, this badge is great.
How do you feel now, bat?
Feel lucky? Oh!
They still hurt you, though.
You just guard, and then you'll be fine.
In the previous game, if you were electrified, the swoopers couldn't hurt you.
Well, they patched that out, I guess.
I bet they call it that because of the way it swoops around.
It's a cute little thing.
Yeah.
Good. So, you think you can take me, eh, bats?
Bats. You know what? That's not even him fighting Batman. That's just Joker looking at a bunch of bats and is like, yeah, come at me, bro!
Yeah.
Joker is the crazy enough son of a bitch that he can just see a flock of bats and just decide he's gonna fight them.
Yeah.
Like, fist fight them or something.
I'm sure he could.
I mean, by his logic, they probably do work for Batman. Oh.
Golden okay, leaf. It's a golden leaf now. It's not a strange leaf.
Oh, I...
Or a stinky herb.
Stinky herb.
Hey, Mario, this kind of smells like skunk.
It's fine, Luigi. Just put it in your pipe. You'll feel right as rain. So is there any reason we're in this, not church? This is supposed to be a church, right?
No, it's a steeple. It's a totally different thing.
No, it's a worship place.
Yeah. Not a church. Totally different. So this had to have been like a star worship place, right?
Yeah, the star church.
Maybe this was...
It's not a good star church because the roof would have to be open, right?
Maybe this was the monotheistic church. That's why it's abandoned.
Wait, go back. What's on the stained glass window?
Just some...
Dude. Oh! It's a church of dude.
All right, back in the hole.
Yeah. That's a god I certainly want to throw my lot behind.
Yeah.
He doesn't look creepy at all. There's no explanation for why this thing exists.
The cult of Mimikyu. He's a lovable Lovecraftian beast.
You know you don't want to go in these woods.
There's a dead rat-a-tat nailed to a tree. Oh, what happened? I guess something did. Oh, the stairs moved.
All by themselves.
Luigi, that's stupid. Obviously, I pushed the switch.
The Nintendo Switch? I hear that's really successful, Mario!
I don't know if it is or not. I can take a look.
Isn't this like... how long has it been out? Like a week?
I think. Nintendo Switch.
Console?
Yeah.
Console?
Console. That's okay, Spirit. You'll go to a place that's slightly better than the place you're at now.
I swear. Oh, this looks like a happy room.
Hang on there, Slick. What are you doing, interrupting my me time?
Oh, is that the god?
That's the monster?
Who are you calling a monster, dick?
Why you got the party time hat going?
Because it's... All the time is party time to this guy. He's the party god.
Party ghost. He's literally just a bedsheet ghost.
Yeah. Just one of the townsfolk wearing a bedsheet.
Instead of wallowing in gloom, I figured they could wallow in mud.
So he's like, he's the closest thing that this universe has to a demon.
I guess, or Loki.
Was that one? Oh, flower point recovery. That's good.
We had this sort of enemy in the previous game, the Dupla Ghost. Remember them?
Yeah. But we don't know who this one is.
Well, it's the party Dupla Ghost.
Maybe. Well, what is it? I don't know.
This thing isn't listed in here, and yet it has an entry number 104. Okay.
Somebody just took the name and just wrote question marks over it.
Yeah. It's apparently really good at transforming itself in other things. So it's like a super Dupla Ghost, a Supla Ghost.
Just use your flower, like, flower attacks that cost flower points, because you'll recover some.
Yeah, I guess I might as well. I actually wasn't paying attention to what the badge did. God damn it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now I'm gonna do this!
Ow.
You just give it up trying to guard, haven't you?
I'm trying to super guard. I'm still trying to get the timing down for this TV. I'm just gonna spin bounce.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I was gonna suggest you just do that, because that's just a six. Oh, nope.
Aha, watch me recover flower points.
Alright. Nice! That was a great setup!
It was very stylish. That's all that matters.
Man, you've gotten really rusty.
It's the TV. Because remember last time we played this was on a CRT.
We're gonna need to get a CRT.
I mean, I have a little CRT.
Use that. I mean, set it up somewhere, like here, and then...
And then we won't have the sound.
Yeah, that is a mild disadvantage.
Also, this is running on HDMI, remember?
Oh, yeah. Oh, oh no, there's it. Fog. There's
fog.
No, It's Zabuza, so he's gonna take out your eight vital points.
Yeah. We just, after a couple seconds, the enemy just falls dead and we don't know what happens.
It's a ninja with a giant ass sword. Ow! Fuck.
It's stealthier than it sounds. Alright.
Steven Bloom in one of his best roles. Besides Orochimaru.
His best Naruto roles, I guess.
Yeah. There's only two of them, so.
He probably was doing bit characters, too.
I bet. Oh, do we beat the boss?
Yeah!
Yeah! Chapter over.
Oh!
We did it!
We got the ruby!
So, first time I played this game...
What?
Remember the first time I played this game? Like, wait, the chapter's over already?
Yeah, it was a very short chapter. So, yeah. How far are we? We're... Hour and 15 minutes, so I guess that's it. Bye, everyone!
let's at least get to Peach.
Mario defeated the Scourge of Creepy Steeple and found the fourth crystal star. The people of Twilight Town have surely recovered from their awful curse by now.
Yeah, surely!
Don't call me Shirley.
Safe.
All right, Peach, what do you got for us?
Wait.
What, we're still here? What a total pushover.
Let's get out of here. What?
Camera?
Why are we still here?
So is the bad guy going to jump up and do something? Let's give him a second. Hello?
Get game. What?
Oh.
Do you know how pissed I was the first time I played this and this happened?
Yeah.
Like, wait, what?
I was just waiting for you to hit the A button. Oh, yeah, I can take a bath. That's nice.
Oh, well, I guess this is my
I guess
now.
I live here now. Let's see what's on the tube.
He's got a TV. It's impressive.
Oh, this chair doesn't rock. They mastered rocking physics in the previous game, but couldn't figure out how to apply it to this one.
Well, they didn't think you'd, like, want to fuck around in that room a lot. They think the player would have more things on their mind than just, oh, look, the chair doesn't rock.
Well, what reason did you have to fuck around in the room in the other game? I guess because you could transform into 8-bit Mario.
Yeah. A feature absent in this game. You can still fight shit. You just don't have any partners, so I guess avoid combat for now.
We'll get Mario and get his map.
Yeah, good luck with that.
This super bomb.
The nuke?
Yeah, we got a nuke.
We got plastique.
We're not cutting corners anymore. We'll nuke the place from orbit.
It's the only way to be sure.
All my witch voices are just Kuratsuchi.
Boss, you sure this is a good idea?
No! We're doing it anyway!
Can't argue with that! Fuck it! No!
I don't like the fuse!
You know, being like an ultra powerful villain, you gotta have, I don't know, confidence.
Yeah. at least he didn't take my coins. I fared better than that bandit in Rogueport.
Just like a villain's like, hey boss, the hero's going to like save the village. What should we do? Like, the villain's like, I don't know, just get guys on it or something.
Let's see how this plays out. I'm sure things will work out.
Just imagine that kind of guy trying to like pump up his troops, just like, alright, I guess we're going like on a fight or something. I don't know.
Everything happens according to God's plan, let's just leave it at that.
Well, that's how they actually did it back then.
Yeah?
They're like, it is God's will that we win this! Can you imagine that? You say that to your troops and then you end up losing the battle? Like,
this too was God's will.
God is testing us.
Dodgy.
You can still use star moves though, right?
Yeah. I got all my moves.
So the guy stole Mario like form, but failed to like take anything that
the first one missed and the second one said nope.
I love it when more games should have like enemies that run away by themselves.
That
I
mean, Spyro had that going for it.
In an RPG,
I know.
But thank you for reminding me of Spyro.
Boss fucked off when he heard a dragon was coming for him.
Boss just left.
When I was doing the 100%ing of that game, by the way, I got the gems from that boss since we never killed him.
Oh. So yeah, you were actually managed to.
Yeah.
No loose ends. Why are you after me? You're a loose end.
Fast travel. Whee! Can't nothing can stop me now! Except a rock.
Yeah,
damn it.
Well, you just hop over it. Hey, what's up, Snake?
Been waiting for you.
Don't ask me how I did that.
Fucking Janemba. I dig this body, too.
I stole your body,
man, now. The chicks I banged.
Try to have a more aggressive pose in that one.
I guess, like, yeah. I need to take your name and body. You can't use your name.
Yeah, I can. My name is Mario.
Shadow Mario.
Can you just imagine Mario's like, of course I'm... And he tries to say Mario, but it doesn't... Oh, it's his name. You're obviously...
Who named their kid that?
It's just Mario.
Ask your
straight
parents.
Up insults him. Oh, I guess. Oh, we're electrified. Maybe this will help.
For a second there, I was watching the right Mario, expecting that. Wait, why are we fighting this fight backwards?
Of course, we saw it coming. Yet.
Bombs.
So we can't hurt him.
But I can be stylish.
Wait. Everybody just threw fucking rocks at you!
And I fucked off. Now I'm the one fleeing.
Dude, the crowd is... Of course the crowd's against you. He's Mario.
Yeah. Everyone loves Mario. I want to see him throw cans at him.
So, you save the village, but nobody's gonna acknowledge your heroism. What's going on here? Oh,
no! I'm through the monsieur!
What the fuck is going on there?
I guess that pig wasn't my husband. Actually, this guy's younger and cuter, is he? Well, the husband looks like Porco Rosso.
Oh, you're gonna cheat on your husband? Wow.
I'm only fooling. Just checking points. Oh, fuck, no.
You currently have 3 points, guy who I've never met before.
Still has access to Mario's account. He has the PIN number.
So this is the worst identity. It's like reverse identity theft.
Yeah.
You hijacked his body, but he knows all like the shit.
I'll store that.
Imagine doing identity theft on like a convict.
Yeah.
That would suck.
Yeah.
The cops would be after you.
Guy looks like Porco Rosso.
That I love that movie was great, but they just didn't explain why he had that curse.
Oh yeah.
It was like, hey, remember when that witch cursed you? Yeah, they never mentioned it again.
Yep, that's all it was.
This is great.
Poor me.
I feel,
what's going on?
I'm glad she's able to join you. Like, it's perfect.
We don't know that yet. I'm looking for something very important.
Oh,
no, wait.
Sorry.
No, this is a... In Japanese, this is a dude. I'm looking for something very important.
Yeah, that's right. Because the Japanese at the time were more tolerant about cross-dressing than America still is.
That's been a thing in Japan for quite a while.
Yeah.
Like, I had you watch... we watched Tokyo Godfathers.
Yeah.
During, around Christmas. Was it around Christmas?
Around that, I guess.
Maybe a little after Christmas. It was after New Year, I think.
We watched that, and,
we had very prominently featured the, cross-dressing Japanese community. The Okama.
Yeah. Okama Kimpo!
I found your nuke. What were you gonna use this for?
It's broken!
Oh no, so what a travesty. Here, I'll fix it.
It's really busted.
Mario the Handyman, weapons specialist.
My name is...
It's like that moment...
I love this line! Well, your name was stolen? I see. Well, I guess that happens from time to time.
No,
it doesn't! I love that.
And so they talk. And fuck. You have way worse problems than I do.
And you were worried about me that whole time.
That's my attempt at Mr. Two.
Straw Boy!
So many really good characters in One Piece.
Yeah. Oh my. Alright, we have a party member.
She's, kinda useful.
Yeah, well, she has her niche. She can set stuff on fire, which is good in a lot of situations. Yeah.
She's the only person that knows fire magic.
Yeah.
Also, she uses stealth, so...
Yeah.
So, crows are assholes, right?
Is it crows or ravens?
Either way, they're assholes.
Yeah. I think, on average... I'm debating who's on average more useful, Bao or Vivian.
Bao had multi-hits.
Yeah.
Especially
which was useless against enemies with defense, but...
But if they had no defense...
It was only good at level 2. Because after that, she dealt the same as other party members, but with the defense weakness.
Ah.
Also, a convenient way to trap you in the town. Can't go back and level her. For some reason, you can't enter the pipe.
For some reason... Wait, what? I didn't see this when I played through.
You know what? I'm just glad they're not attacking me on sight for there being a Shadow Siren with me.
KOS! KOS!
Oh, I didn't even move. He just started talking.
Yeah.
Please take this as a token of our thanks. Eat up. Who might you be? I don't remember inviting any shadows to my house. Get out! We don't need any. If you don't need anything, please leave. Ha! Look at me! It's me, Mario!
Not even acknowledging you.
You sure got chatty all of a sudden. You, like, never talk.
This is suspicious.
Guess it's not totally weird. You seem kind of different. You're kind of like the life of the party. I guess that's it. Party Mario!
Party Mario. Shot, 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 shot.
You're rather dramatic of late, aren't you? I rather enjoyed your quiet dignity and strength of character. Thank you. Liked the Chad Mario. You're kind of freaking me out, Gonzales. I'm all for acting like a loon, but that's not your character.
Out of character? That's weird.
Alright, so I guess we go right and then Vivian says something, maybe? And maybe she already said about the,
yeah, birds know shit!
This twilight world is too full of pain and contradiction. Too full of broken dreams.
Perhaps I was only given wings so that I could flee the terror of mundanity.
Okay, Edgar Allan Poe.
Nevermore.
I'm sad that I did a really good reading of that for the college radio at one point, but they lost the recording.
Aw, man.
Of the Raven.
That's disappointing.
So that Mario guy meeting with the mayor, he's actually the bad guy, right? And nobody even knows. Humans are so dumb, it makes me want to peck their noses.
Yeah, we're bigger than you. Shut up.
Bad guy, someone who knows the name is locked under a creepy steeple. Alright.
Hey, I think they listened to our talk to the other ones first.
Oh, the other ravens?
Yeah, they got funny shit to say.
Eavesdropping.
Hey, Maud, listen to this. Ronnie, my oldest...
Taking his SATs this year.
What?!
Bless my feathers, Theo. Oh, there's Theo. So that other guy was Porco.
Oh man, that witch cursed her as well.
I guess these have to be crows because we've seen ravens in Mario.
No, ravens are much more chill.
They're little pudgy dudes.
Yeah.
They were also kind of dicks until they warmed up to you, though.
Yeah.
I was chatting with Rotbeak in Mushroom Town on Instant Messenger yesterday.
Instant Messenger?
Yeah, I got this pigeon friend. I sent him off, he'll do anything for me.
He's got fiber optic.
Crows are way ahead of the other mushroom technology. They're hoarding it to themselves.
Why the fuck do crows have that kind of tech?
I bet he's downloading 100 meg apps with no problems on those fat pipes.
Oh.
The Feather Club for Crows site.
All this information age.
It's all games and feather loss sites that are driving the technology.
Feather loss? You're a bird. You need them. You need those.
Alright, what do you guys got?
A
been really depressed lately, thinking about the depletion of fossil fuels.
Come on!
So these are all just college students.
They're millennials. Or at least a person's interpretation of millennials.
The millennial crows.
Millennial, title of this video, Millennial Crows.
Good name for a band.
Oh, you want me to tell you about my hacktivism? Hey, Slick! I saw you at the mayor's house!
This is just every time we go through this map.
Yep.
He just says, sorry, party members. I'm gonna fuck off for a little while. Hang out here. Well, gee, Mario never did that before.
She doesn't recognize Mario on sight.
He looks kind of familiar. You get your real name back. Alright, fire away.
Fuckface.
The game doesn't even scold you.
Is this same okay? Fuckface. Hey, fuck.
Oh, now that's kind of starting to get hurtful.
You stole my identity, you dick.
Fuck you.
Electrification.
Get him! Nope.
No,
see, that doesn't make sense why she can't hurt him.
Because Mario is that... No, he was able to super guard.
Oh, okay. But then wouldn't I have taken... I can get whatever.
He equipped in a bunch of defense ups.
He equipped a ton of defense ups, attack downs. That's the only reason that we can't hurt each other.
I don't remember if those badges still exist in this game or not, or if they were just Paper Mario 1 badges.
See, that's how much his arsenal sucks, is that he's still using Paper Mario badges when they've been rendered obsolete.
Outdated technology. He's gotta learn a thing or two from the crows.
See, they don't use badges anymore. They got apps they get to install on their phone that increases their attack for them.
Is that gonna be the next Paper Mario? You equip apps? That'd be kind of insufferable.
Well, then that would be measured in megabytes.
Yeah. Oh, I'm dodgy. So the same thing might happen.
No, because Vivian's there. Oh wait, she can only do 2 damage, right?
Fuck, wrong. Okay, no, it's
4 damage!
It's super effective against plants.
Oh! This one's ballsy.
Yeah, to be fair, it did hit.
No, we've been unlucky with that, at least.
Yeah. I actually pressed the wrong button first, so it's pretty generous on the timing.
Yeah.
Mine.
Mine.
I mean, for a Mario game, it does a pretty good job of being, you know, like a fairly haunting chapter.
Yeah.
Within the limits.
That doesn't go, Doesn't go full-on creepypasta on you.
I would love a full-on Mario Majora's Mask, though.
Oh, like the creepy Mario?
Yes.
That game's gimmick is that you put on different masks to turn into different creatures.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, we've done that already. Whoa. Fuck! The danger is that Peach has already been turned into a vampire and you gotta find the cure.
Okay, sure.
Yeah. There's a controversial scene in which Bowser is shown crucified.
Or something to do with, like, all the stars have vanished from the sky and the game's all about shadows like this.
Oh, man. There's a lot of good ideas in the world.
Yeah. Alright, into the steeple from the sewers or whatever. Why was there a tunnel in the well? Was this the priest's escape?
Yeah.
In case those asshole star cultists those star believers came to settle down the monotheist...
The Star Inquisition.
Yeah, to invade the monotheistic church.
There's only one god, you fucking idiot! There's like eight of them!
That's heresy. Whee! Just a tube.
Alright.
I got the letter P.
That's so weird that
the steeple key.
He stole P, so in case you can't, like, bullshit it beforehand.
The fourth wall. Oh. Hello. Oh,
that's good.
Badges, there we go.
Lucky start in Quakehammer? Oh, really?
For now. Otherwise, yeah, I guess I could get rid of Quakehammer for now. It's that, or I could get rid of some HP FP. Oh, HP plus. I don't need HP plus partner. Fuck that.
Are you serious? All right.
I'm not for 6 badge points. If it were 3, maybe, but.
Yeah. Oh. Good morning. Good morning.
It's great to stay up late. What happened to those weirdos? It's almost nice to have some company. Making me guard the name stupid missing letter. I hate you, Dupless, you baka!
Dupless! We know your turn. Pretty bird, pretty bird. Dude, I'm pretty sure that bird wouldn't be so broken up if Dupless died.
No.
Like, yeah, he's forcing you to, like, be locked up. Like,
what if that bird became a party member? Like, you free him from his job and now he's just hanging around?
Dude, I would almost prefer those, like, Super Mario Brothers Ravens to be a party member.
Yeah.
Because that would be pretty cool. Just
have a Raven party member.
That, and we're missing, as far as Super Mario creatures, that, Ninji...
I mean, there are a few that we could say. I guess we did have a Boo party member with Bo.
Chain Chomp party member.
Yeah. Blooper.
What?
Blooper.
Oh, that'd be cool!
Daisy. Buzzy. Pretty much, think of all Luigi's party members that we see, and we don't have any of those.
I almost want them. Almost.
Yeah. Just a game where you can, it's like Fire Emblem, you can recruit dozens and dozens of people to your army.
That's what Mario never did is a tactical, like, RPG.
Yeah.
It's like Fire Emblem. That'd be cool. Mario X
Mario Fire. Warriors.
Mario Warriors.
Mushroom Warriors.
Mushroom Warriors. That just sounds like a bunch of people tripping balls with swords and charging at their enemy.
Or a gay porn.
Wait, a gay porn?
Yeah. Because everyone's got mushrooms.
That's a stretch. Punch. Wait, what happened? Oh!
He's dodgy now, so I'll just hit everywhere at once!
That's not gonna work. Oh, it did work!
Fuck you, it's not gonna work! That's impossible, you say?!
Missed
it point blank. He was helpless, Vivian. You suck.
Just hit him.
I was seeing what the guy was throwing.
He got him!
Mario used feint attack. It never misses.
Is that really the thing in, like, Pokemon? Is that feint attack never misses?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
There are a few attacks like that. Aerial Ace is a flying type one.
More coins.
Swift.
Quick attack does miss, though.
Yeah. Swift is in Gen 1 and never misses. So there's like a TM for that you can get. Oh, this fucker.
Can't use tri-attack, though.
Nope, running. Tri-attack, the ultimate if it works.
3 flavors of if it works.
I love how this is our fastest mode of travel without Yoshi.
Just log rolling.
Yep.
Alright.
amuse me with one more guess. Hit me one more time. Even if you do it like a Pokemon style in all caps, he says, no, that's stupid, that doesn't count.
You are dupless.
What did you just say?
Dupless. No.
Time to fuck off. And guess where he went?
Going back to the woods.
Back to the steeple. All the way through the woods.
Because why not? There's not a whole lot going on in this chapter, honestly.
There's not a lot of maps. It's just walking back and forth across the same maps over and over.
Yeah. This is the church. This is the steeple.
This is for booze. This is for people. Damn it! Get over here. Don't stop short. He knows what I'm up to. Come here. That dumbass.
Yeah! What dumbass?
Oh god, hypers. Wow, Power Plus is amazing on Mario.
Yeah. Oh no, what?
Aww. It scared the punies away.
I've never seen that happen before.
It happens. I don't have, I just realized I don't have the spike protection badge. I don't remember when I get that.
Soon, maybe?
Hopefully.
He's going all in!
That's cute. Bye.
That was completely unnecessary.
That's okay, I'm leveling up.
Oh, you are. Okay, never mind. Level up.
Even with the fake start, I think this is a pretty short, probably the shortest chapter, though.
Yeah. What's the longest one that's bit?
Maybe. See, if this were in Paper Mario 1, we couldn't have been able to get any more badge points from here.
Yeah. But, sky's the limit.
Man, it'd be real nice to have that spike badge.
Yeah.
Are there any onesies I can get rid of? Here, you know what?
No quake hammer. Hammer throw.
Yeah, my base is covered.
And healing. Good.
I think the swoopers are the only enemies anywhere near here that would need any of those. Well, I guess quake hammer was good because of the-
Oh!
Oh, and I don't have Goombella.
Damn it!
I'm gonna have to be real good at this, and it's probably not gonna happen.
That was pretty okay. You think it'll kill him that turn?
No. But if it attacks, I'm going to die.
Oh, man. That sucks. Do it.
I wonder if I should veil. I'm gonna do it.
I want to.
I'm not taking chances. Ah, soundproof.
It runs!
Oh, okay, good.
Alright, finish the fight.
Oh, what? God, that takes both turns. Oh, good, okay. Okay, so Veil takes both turns, not just one turn like it did in the last game.
That sucks! That's worse!
It is definitely worse.
Why would you do something like that?
Balance it.
It was already balanced. You couldn't use your partner.
Yeah. Gone. I guess it can refresh itself, but it also has a chance to wake you, so.
Alright. That's so stupid. That is so bad.
I mean, it's still going to defend you against really big attacks. Just Amazing Daisies are rare in that they do the big attacks every turn if they attack.
Yeah, so.
I could really go for a sub sandwich right now.
You know that Subway up by Winco? That's open 24/7.
Ah. I'm not going to get one right now. I'm just. If I were, I'd probably just go to Safeway, but.
It's because of the smell of my food?
Nah, I got Safeway Chinese.
Oh, nice. Man. This dupless guy didn't think things through, huh?
No. No.
Go for it. Hey, I'm dupless. I'm going to take your name and then leave you alive.
Like, Mario was just a happy accident to him. His end game was just fucking with the townsfolk, and that was the extent of it.
This guy is... Dupless is useless.
Doesn't have a lot of ambition.
No ambition. He's got as much ambition as fucking that one mad scientist from, he has as much ambition as Powerpuff Girls Z Mojo Jojo.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, Mojo has the ambition. He just doesn't know how the fuck to make it happen.
Oh. Well, who doesn't have ambition? Like...
There was a character, I think, that felt like there was a Powerpuff character we complained about not having enough ambition. Or, someone like Mojo. Who's another Saturday morning? No, it wasn't Eggman.
Was it a guy in Shaolin Showdown, you think?
Chase?
Chase Young.
Yeah, he was the guy with all the power, but no he didn't
ambition.
Want to do anything with it.
None! No ambition at all!
He was just, his cult character arc was, we wait. We'll do something eventually.
then you got one guy spying on him, and then the guy spying on the guy spying on him.
Yeah.
That was really great. Like, I love how the series just evolved into people spying on other people while they're spying on other people.
So many sects of villains in that show, all active at the same time.
And very rarely do they cooperate. Here we go.
Hey, you follow me all the way up here, eh, Slick? And they're right there. Don't notice a thing.
You dolts.
He teamed up with a Shadow Siren, the Fiend. Very good, my loyal ones. How dare this nameless nobody? Fucking heal Mario.
Dude, heal Mario like NWO Mario.
That means you are Mario?
He's wearing sunglasses and wears black and white and just plays an air guitar.
Fight with your girlfriend? Oh yeah, so she found out we're Mario.
Whatever. Is that like... Oh, she's not gonna...
Hello?
There we go.
We've been abandoned.
Yuck, yuck.
You don't have the charisma.
So... Oh, we're electrified.
Come get me, bruh.
So don't kill any of your partners. Cause then if you don't want to fight a dragon.
What?
I'm saying you don't want to fight dragon. Don't kill Gumella.
Oh, I guess it's dragon. You think dragon be really tough?
Yeah. Besides, if you beat Dupless, you end the battle.
I know, but we could fight the partners just to show them a lesson.
I'm giving you a veto on that. Oh, they might kill themselves anyway. Nope.
I want to do it.
No. I'll smack you. You're seriously doing it?
Yeah.
Fucking hell, dude. You're an idiot.
Yeah. I want to see what happens. I've never done it before.
Oh my god, we're gonna be here all night. My god, dude.
Okay, he's fighting. She's fighting with us now. We're good.
I want to fight the guy.
I want to be the guy. Here, I'll set him on fire. You hussy.
Yeah, beat your partners.
Yeah.
Like, you're a hero.
Mario, don't let your guard down. She says that she's on fire. Oh god, she knows multibonk!
Yeah, that's what you get for dicking around.
Dried shroom!
Alright.
Fuck.
Man, sometimes you just like to push my buttons. You're like, I'm gonna kill all the guys!
I've never done it before. I mean,
play fun. You decide now on stream is a good time to start?
Yeah?
Fine, do what you want.
Fine, I'll set him on fire. As long as everyone's on fire, I'm happy. God damn it. Okay, good. If I can do that, it ends it immediately.
Yeah.
Probably should heal again.
Alright.
I don't have any healing items!
Whose fault is that?
I don't know. Yours?
Why is it my fault?!
Well, you asked. Obviously, it can't be my fault.
Man, you're a jerk. Yeah, you're the one who's insisting, no! Let's fight all of our partners!
Yeah!
No, it's a good idea, trust me!
It's a great idea.
Yeah, and I'm gonna say I told you so, and when it fucking blows up in your face, as it inevitably will, like, all your good ideas.
If we were on a CRT TV, this would be a better idea.
Yeah, either connect the CRT so you can get better at combat, or do the bare minimum.
Are you scolding me for not doing the bare minimum?
I'm scolding you for taking unnecessary risks like you do.
I want to at least kill Goombella. Super Mario's hurting.
Oh. Wow, is Goombella literally invincible?
I don't think so. You dead now?
No.
Okay, I guess she lives.
More than 10 HP, I guess.
I'll just leave her on fire, I guess.
Why? How?
See, we were never in any danger, and you were worried.
Mario!
Oh, yeah, we were never in any danger.
Now, the amazing
3
Daisy.
HP. That was... No, it's like a guy with a gunshot, like, I'm not gonna die soon.
Now, the amazing Daisy, that was scary. Yay!
I'm just waiting for you to slip up, and then you die.
And we got the most powerful star attack, too.
Oh, is that really the one?
Well, against a single opponent, it's the most useful. Isn't she one of the Shadow Sirens?
It's okay. She's a friend now.
You think in the Japanese version, the Yoshu is like, "What are you doing with that stupid queer?" or something stupid.
No!
Like no?
Easy. A hero in a Mario game isn't allowed to be bigoted.
No. Even if it's a little punk kid?
I don't think a punk kid knows what, like, would use... Well, okay, never mind. I take that back.
I mean, the guy in Tokyo Godfather was a pretty big asshole about it.
Yeah. Then again, they were friends, so...
Yeah.
It's like... I don't know.
For reals this time! And the Duplis jumps back up for round two.
Wait! Just a second!
Second form, didn't see that coming. The quest is more than half over. Well, technically there are 8 chapters, so...
Well, there's 8 chapters and then, oh fuck, we gotta dive into the fucking, past the 1,000-year door now.
But what about the other sisters, and what happened to Duplis?
an alliance.
That was actually our shortest thing. It's still just under 2 hours.
Is it really just under 2 hours?
1:55.
That's our... Oh, after the hell that was Glitz Pit, this is a welcome change.
Yeah. So are we done?
I guess so. Like, yeah. I guess if you want to, we could just do pre-Peach Bowser, just get it out of the way.
Yeah. What's the next chapter? Oh, next chapter's gonna be long.
That one?
Is
that
Island.
The... Oh, fuck!
Let's get Peach and Bowser out of the way.
Yeah, because that one's gonna take a while. Wait! Oh!
She's very late.
Good scene.
Zach, we're getting annoyed with you there. It's just like, are you really wanting to drag this out longer?
Never done it before. Hey, longer, it's a short video. Speak up, Crossnut.
Yes, sir. You can tell he's a scientist because he has a clipboard.
The ceiling power has definitely been weakening.
The ceiling power? Oh, our so fans are spinning slightly slower.
So the stars are irrelevant.
They're irrelevant?
Yeah, the ceiling power of the door.
Well, I guess they need to get in there anyway, so...
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, Mario's doing my handiwork.
Oh, so he's just a narcissist. He wants to build a new world all about himself.
He just wants to take over the world so he can build giant statues of himself.
Do you think that's Eggman?
Obviously not, but I'm sure if he was based off of Eggman, yeah.
Well, it's like maybe Eggman died and he put his brain in a robot body. Learn some.
Eggman can't die.
Learn some technological magic.
Eggman's the kind of person who, when he sees his base attacks being attacked, he laughs about it. It's like, oh, what a mess.
Yeah.
That was great.
Base was under siege by the government, and he's like, oh, that's cute. Makes me feel unpleasant if I make you worry. Let's have a quiz.
Answer my questions carefully.
Tech's acting weird. What will you happen if you collect seven? Your wish is granted by the Eternal Dragon!
Incorrect. Oh my god, you know.
1,000 coins appear!
Oh god! Second question. What is the goal of Gerudas? Conquer the world to get rich.
To become a superhero!
Crazy fucking goal. What is the legendary treasure?
Are you supposed to be telling me this? 100 million coins! An extremely rare badge! 1,000-year-old demon soul!
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, wait! They used the term demon?
Yeah?
Oh my god, check the water, is it muddy?
Darkest Paper Mario game.
Is the water muddy?
What does Sir Grotus wish to do with this ancient demon soul? Hang out with it. Or
I mean,
cherish it always.
Technically, the third answer is kind of true.
Yeah.
Fifth question.
What is required? A legendary sword. No, that's a different RPG.
That's a different game.
Magic spell.
That closer.
Also in a different RPG, probably. Crystal stars.
Hey, Mario, you use a sword. What is this? This feels weird.
What do you think I am, Sonic?
It's not heavy at the very end. I can't use this. Oh, so Tech was like, I could tell you this, but...
That would be, like, against protocol. So let's just have a quiz. You're still a weird computer, Tech.
Okay, Princess Peach. Waifu.exe has shut down.
Alright, sure. What do you got for us, Bowser? We gonna go rampaging somewhere? We got a level this time?
We do stuff. Ah! Wait, what?
Again? I've received reports of a great secret in the floating
town
of Blitzville.
You've been there before!
Is the Bowser delayed? Was this actually going on while we were in Glitzville? And we're only just seeing it now? We just got the videotapes?
So, this is, Quentin Tarantino, anachronistic order. Quentin Tarantino presents Super Paper Mario 1,000 Year Door.
We took some liberties. Does he look like a bitch to you?
Define what Lord Bowser looks like. He's fat. Go on. He's got a spiked shell. Koopish motherfucker, do you speak it?
tried to do Bowser ended up going to him in pain.
Uh-oh. Oh, well, my voice is fucked up, so.
Yeah. No, I mean, I did.
Oh. So, how do you make it to Glitzville, then?
He didn't.
But, he I did.
Ready to roll.
Oh. He can kind of swim.
Yeah. Well, everyone can swim in Smash Brothers.
Yeah.
Uh-oh! Bowser, jump! No, I guess he couldn't swim there.
So you can only swim for a limited amount of time before his arms get tired, I guess. So he's like Tails.
Yeah. That was... Okay, that was just weird. Yeah, everything needs a rock remix.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm bigger now.
They're really generous with the power-ups in Bowser Brothers.
Well, it's not like it's supposed to be taken seriously, I guess. Yeah.
Part of me wishes it were taken a little more seriously so that there was actually some threat of not getting through the level.
They did take it seriously. It's called Super Paper Mario.
Eh.
I'm wrong?
That wasn't as much about the platforming.
Oh. It was a weird hybrid game.
Yeah.
Part of me wishes I want to try it out again, but... Don't you own it?
Well, yeah, we could stream it after, you know...
Would it be quicker or slower than...
Probably quicker than these. I don't remember the chapter as being as long, certainly.
Ah. Oh, you got to Glitzville, I guess.
Well, you got to the end of the water level. Like, we could do it after this one if you were ever so inclined.
I wouldn't be looking forward to it as much, though. Maybe. Also, I've never played it, so.
Yeah.
It's something I could play again.
I would rather you played it than have to play it again myself, okay. Is my answer.
Wow, that bad, huh?
Not my type of game, I guess.
I'll play it.
I've been looking all over.
I've been at Glitzville.
I've been swimming.
Glitzville was fantastic. The fights were so cool.
So why is this part positing that Bowser didn't get there when we obviously know that's not true?
I guess this disproves our Tarantino anachronism theory.
Maybe he goes there afterwards?
Or he was just there earlier and then he went to the tree and then he found out about the Crystal Star. Like, the first time he went there, he just went there because he heard Mario was there. And then he later found out about the Crystal Star.
This is a giant plot hole.
I guess.
Like...
I mean, I kind of just explained it, but...
Okay, yeah, we can do that. So he goes there, then like, oh, I lost against Mario. He's like, I gotta go back there. So they were there before, they just were there all business, though.
Yeah. It was a fake Mario all that time. Did we hurt your feelings?
Maybe a little.
Well, alright, it's okay to be in touch with your feelings. Need to get back to Rogueport, okay.
Yeah, sure. We just used Vivian the entire time, we didn't mention anybody else. This is your punishment.
But wait, how could she go through? She didn't have her name written somewhere.
Alright, is that it?
Mario had to scribble it.
Oh.
Would that be an email? It's the spirit of a demon!
It's a demon spirit. I can't believe... Some scientists want to resurrect a demon so they can rule the world.
Then Mario's just looking at this. Mario, what's it say? Does the crazy sign? I think Princess Peach has lost it.
She's been broken.
Demons, we don't have those in our games.
Wait, what's a demon? That's what Mario should be saying.
Yeah.
The spirit of a demon. What's a demon? Just a fairy tale, they don't exist.
I remembered something that I can get real quick, and then I'll save and we're done.
Alright, go ahead.
Not gonna bother.
You're not worth it. Imagine a guy naming their child not worth it.
I don't think the doctors would allow that.
Have you named your child? I want to name it not worth it. No.
Be an eternal reminder of the mistake that she is.
God, I would feel so bad for that child.
Yeah.
Like, how dare you? I ought to beat the shit out of you, parent.
Go and upgrade her. You're getting the royal treatment, Vivian.
Well, shine sprites will buff you up because you're part shadow and light makes shadows bigger.
You just joined and you're already getting buffed.
See, this is how good of a boss Mario is. He just like, new bug guy, I'll grant you power.
Yeah.
It's better than her sisters were treating her, like.
Yeah. You're getting very somber towards the end of this video.
I don't like seeing
some heavy shit in this Mario game, yo.
I don't like seeing people get mistreated.
Yeah.
Despite how I may act, I don't ever, like... I may act in kind of frustration, but I don't, like, do that all the time. And never to a level where I'm seriously pissed. I hope not, at least.
Yeah. Here we go, here we are. Remember this place?
Oh, no. Oh. Oh, we can... Timing is perfect.
So I was talking about where I get the spike shield badge.
Fuck you, game!
Nope, I can't get spiked back to the start. Vivian wasn't ready. Can you imagine if I died here?
I would get pissed again. Well.
Okay.
Back
up to the save point.
I guess that while you're down here, you might as well just. We'll
do that next time.
All right.
We'll have a clean start to the chapter.
I guess so.
Not one of those dirty starts.
Chapter where you just go in and, like, rather than getting shunted immediately to X-Not shit. That was a save point back there.
I know, but there's Dazzle here!
Oh.
Ooh, we got a lot. Flower Saver. Ooh, another power plus. Yeah!
Oh! The ultimate power.
I need more power. I can also get power plus P.
Unlimited power! I'd almost rather you get, like, flowers. Wait, that's also 6, right?
It's 4. I already have 1 flower saver, though.
What'd you get as well?
Power plus P.
Okay.
Get a happy heart P, happy flower. Or I'll save for the flower savers.
Yeah.
Or quick change.
Quick change. You never equipped that, though.
No, I don't know how much it costs in this game. It might be 4.
God, it has to be, like, a 1 thing. Like...
Alright, now we're done.
Never done for reals this time.
Yeah, we'll see you next time.
See you next time.
Whenever we come back to this game.
Hopefully my voice gets better.
Yeah.
This is kind of annoying.
Pokemon tomorrow is the plan.
I don't want to listen to this episode back. Like, usually I just kind of listen to myself. I don't want to.
Yeah.
I probably sound hideous.
That's okay. It'll pass.
I hope so.
See you later, guys.
Take care.